In this video, I'm going to show you how to solve this parity error that you may run into when solving the edge pieces on a 5x5 Rubik's Cube. Check out my other video showing you how to solve a 2x2 Rubik's Cube, a 3x3, a 4x4, and even a 5x5. So when solving the 5x5 Rubik's Cube, you may run into this parity error. First, you've completed all the center pieces. And then the next step is you start lining up all the edge pieces, and you've completed every single edge piece, as in you've got all three colours the same, except for one. The last one, you've got the three colours on the correct edge, except they're sort of in an alternate pattern. Now this is a parity error that you may run into. However, if you watch my tutorial on how to solve the edge pieces, I teach you a way where you'll never actually run into this parity error anyway. So you can avoid running into this parity error. And if you want to learn how to do that, then watch my tutorial on how to solve the edge pieces on a 5x5 Rubik's Cube. But if you have run into this parity error somehow, or you just want to learn how to get out of the parity error, I'm going to show you now. So this parity error, if you look at it, is basically the same parity error that you run into on the 4x4. Remember on the 4x4 when you come to make the blue cross on the top, sometimes you get this blue on the side and the other colour on the top and the other three are correct. Well, that's a parity error on the 4x4. Well, it's the same on the 5x5, just think these two are wrong. And we will use the same algorithm that we used to solve the parity error on the 4x4. We'll use the same one on the 5x5. So if you've already memorized the algorithm, then you already know how to get out of this parity error. Now, if you haven't, or you don't know how to solve a 4x4, unfortunately, the algorithm for this is quite long. That's why I teach you a method where you avoid this parity error altogether. So the algorithm that we will use is the algorithm from the 4x4, and that algorithm is double R in brackets 2, B2, U2, double L in brackets, U2, double R in brackets inverse, U2, double R in brackets, U2, F2, double R in brackets, F2, double L in brackets inverse, B2, double R in brackets 2. Okay, and the edge piece we're working on, we're on the top front face, like this, and we're going to flip these two pieces. So let's do the algorithm. Double R in brackets 2, B2, U2, double L in brackets, U2, double R in brackets inverse, U2, double R in brackets, U2, F2, double R in brackets, F2, double L in brackets inverse, B2, double R in brackets 2. And that has corrected these two pieces and corrected the parity error. Now we basically have a scrambled 3x3. And as a teacher on my 5x5 video, you now solve it the same way you would a 3x3. As I said before, if you want to avoid running into this parity error, therefore you don't need to learn this really long algorithm, then check out my other video showing you how to solve the edge pieces on a 5x5, and I'll show you the method on how to avoid running into this parity error altogether. Hope it helped, guys, and thanks for watching.